Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the D flip-flop. So in the previous video, we learned about the SR flip-flop. And we have seen that when its both inputs are 1, then it is difficult to predict the output of this flip-flop. And that is why it is not suitable for many sequential circuits. So this issue can be resolved using other flip-flops like D flip-flop or the JK flip-flop. So in this particular video, we will see the D flip-flop. So the issue with this SR flip-flop can be resolved if we ensure that both S and R inputs are not 1 at the same time. And the same thing is done in this D flip-flop. So here, with the little modification in this SR flip-flop, it can be used as the D flip-flop. So as you can see, here this D input is directly connected to the S input. And through the NOT gate, the same input is connected to the R input. That means now, when this D is equal to 1, then this S is 1 and this R is 0. And similarly, when this D is 0, then this S is 0 and R is 1. So in this way, both S and R are not 1 at the same time. And just using this one input, we can set and reset this D flip-flop. So here, when there is a no clock transition, then irrespective of the value of this D input, the flip-flop will hold its current state. That means previously, if Qn is 0, then the Qn plus 1 will also remain 0. And likewise, if Qn is 1, then in the next state, the Qn plus 1 will remain 1. Now at the clock transition, when this D input is equal to 0, then this S is 0 and R is 1. So in this case, irrespective of the present state of the flip-flop will get reset. That means its output will become 0. Similarly, when this D input is equal to 1, then this S is 1 and R is 0. So in this case, irrespective of the value of the present input at the clock transition, the output of the flip-flop will become 1. So this is the symbol of the positive edge triggered D flip-flop, and this is its truth table. So in short, from the truth table we can say that when there is a no clock transition, then the flip-flop will hold its current state, and at the clock transition, the next state of the flip-flop will be same as the input. That means if the input is equal to 0, then in the next state, the output will be equal to 0, and if the input is equal to 1, then in the next state, the output will also become 1. So in this way, this flip-flop stores the information at the every clock transition. So this flip-flop is used in the data registers as well as in the counters. So likewise, this is the symbol of the negative edge triggered D flip-flop. So as you can see, there is a small bubble over here, which indicates that the flip-flop responds to the input only at the falling edge of the clock. Alright. So now with the help of this timing diagram, let us understand the behavior of the D flip-flop. And first, let us take the case of the positive edge triggered flip-flop. So here, this D is the input, while this CLK is the clock pulse which is given to the D flip-flop. So initially, here the output of the flip-flop is equal to 0. Now at the rising edge of the clock, this D input also becomes 1. And therefore, the output of the flip-flop will also become 1, and it will remain in that state until the next clock transition. That means in between, even if the D input changes, then also the output will remain high. Now once again, at the next rising edge if you see, then here this D input is equal to 0, and therefore the output Q will also become 0, and it will remain in that state until the next clock transition. Now at the next rising edge if you see, then still this D input is equal to 0. And therefore, this output Q will remain 0. And it will remain in that state until the next rising edge. So this is the Q output of this D flip-flop. And if you see the Q bar output, then it will be the exactly opposite of the Q output. So similarly, for the same input signal, now let us see the output of the negative edge triggered flip-flop. So here, initially this Q output is equal to 0. So this flip-flop will hold its present state until the next falling edge. That means up to this point, the output Q will remain 0. Now at the first falling edge, if you see, then here this D input is equal to 0, and therefore this Q output will remain in the same state, and it will remain in that state until the next falling gauge. That means up to this point, this Q output will remain 0. Now once again at the next falling gauge, if you see, then now this D input is equal to 1, and therefore this Q output will also become 1, and it will remain in that state until the next falling gauge. That means up to this point, this Q output will remain 1. Now once again at the next falling gauge, if you see, then here this D input is equal to 0, and therefore this Q output will also become 0, and it will remain in that state until the next falling gauge. So if you see the overall Q output, then it will look like this, and this Q bar output will be exactly opposite to the Q output. So in this way, with the help of the timing diagram, we have seen the behavior of this positive as well as the negative edge triggered D flip-flop. So now, let us see the different representation of the flip-flop. So there are different ways to represent the characteristic or the behavior of the flip-flop. So these are the four different ways using which we can represent the behavior of the flip-flop. So one is of course the truth table. And about the truth table, we already know. Apart from that, the other representations are this characteristic equation, the excitation table, and the state transition diagram. So about this state transition diagram, we will see in the separate video. But in this video, let us talk about the characteristic equation and the excitation table. And first, let us start with the characteristic equation. So this characteristic equation is basically the representation of the next state of the flip-flop in terms of the present state as well as the current inputs. So basically, it shows the behavior of the flip-flop in the algebraic form. So now, let us see the characteristic equation of this D flip-flop in terms of the present state Qn and the D input. So here, for the two variables Qn and the D, we have total four different input combinations. So for the D flip-flop, we have already seen that when this D input is 0, then irrespective of the present value of the Qn, in the next state, this Qn plus 1 will remain 0. And likewise, when this D input is equal to 1, then whether this Qn is either 0 or 1, in the next state, this Qn plus 1 will remain 1. So clearly, as you can see, this Qn plus 1 is same as the D input. And therefore, we can say that this Qn plus 1 is equal to D. So this is the characteristic equation of this D flip-flop. Similarly, let us see the excitation table of this D flip-flop. So this excitation table is very useful during the synthesis or the design of the digital circuits. So if you see the excitation table, then it looks as if we are looking at the truth table in the reverse way. So basically, it shows the required input or the required excitation to the flip-flop to go from the one state of the flip-flop to the next particular state. So currently, let's say this Qn is equal to 0. Now in the next state, if we want the Qn plus 1 to be 0, then this D input should be equal to 0. Because we have seen that for the D flip-flop, the output follows the input. Similarly, currently if Qn is equal to 1, and in the next state, if we want this Qn plus 1 to be 0, then once again, this D input should be equal to 0. Likewise, irrespective of the current state of the Qn, in the next state, if we want this Qn plus 1 to be equal to 1, then this D input should be equal to 1. So this is the excitation table of this D flip-flop. Alright, so now let us see the internal circuit of this D flip-flop. So first, we will see the circuit of the D latch and the gated D latch. And then we will see that how it can be converted into the D flip-flop. So this is the basic circuit of this SR latch. Now in this circuit, just by adding one more NOT gate, it can be converted into the D latch. So here, when this D input is equal to 0, then this S is 0 and R is 1. And since R is 1 and S is 0, so the output of the flip-flop will become 0. Likewise, when this D is equal to 1, then this S is 1 and R is 0. And therefore, the output of the flip-flop will become 1. So this is the basic circuit of the D latch. And likewise, with the same little modification, this gated SR latch can be converted into the gated D latch. So as you can see, this portion of the circuit is the gated SR latch. And just by using one more NOT gate, it can be converted into the gated D latch. So as you can see, when this enable input is equal to low, then irrespective of the value of the D input, the latch will hold its present state. Because when this enable input is 0, then both inputs S' and R' will be 0. And therefore, the latch will hold its present state. Now when this enable input is high, then the latch will become transparent. And in that case, the output will be same as the D input. That means if D input is equal to 0, then the output is also 0. And when this D input is equal to 1, then the output is also 1. So this is the truth table of this gated D latch. And in this gated D latch, just by adding the clock transition circuit, it can be converted into the D flip flop. So in the previous video of the SR flip flop, we have already discussed this pulse transition circuit. So in case if you have not watched that video, then please go through that video to get the more information. So basically this is the circuit of the D flip flop. So similarly, in the next couple of videos, we will learn about the T flip flop and the JK flip flop. But I hope in this video, you learned about the D flip flop. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.